These progressive Christians and pastors don't even understand the first thing about Jesus. It gets wild. They don't understand why he came to die, and they don't understand the first thing about who he was. I'm responding to some videos today from TikTok. You're going to want to stick around. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Isaac David, and this is The Daily Disciple, where I help you follow Jesus daily. If you're new to the channel, I put out videos every single day, which is kind of wild. I do some longer ones like this one and some shorter videos daily. The only reason that I'm able to do that is because of the people on Patreon. It's because of your guys' support, supporting Daily Disciple Ministry and myself. It's the reason I can continue to put out videos helping people find Jesus and follow him daily. So if you want to help me in that mission as well, you can head on over to the link in my bio, patreon.com/daily_disciple. Now let's get into the video. So as I was thinking about video topics for today, this idea of who Jesus was and is kept going into my mind because it's so fundamental to our lives as believers. You think about it, if you get the character of Jesus wrong or you misunderstand what he was here to do or who he was, it's going to alter the way you live your life and how you behave as a Christian. After all, as Christians, we are disciples. There's no, oh, Christian that's not a disciple. No, if you are a Christian, if you are bought by the blood of Jesus, if you have put in your faith in Jesus and repented for your sin, you are a disciple. You are a follower of Jesus. So how can you follow somebody that you don't even understand, you don't even know? And that's the huge thing about kind of modern progressive Christianity, is they're distorting who Jesus is in order to fit their own box, their own idea of who he should be, and it's distorting the way that they live their lives. It's mangling it, and it's creating all sorts of confusion and just chaos. And so part of the reason I want to do this is not only point out the error, which I think is important, but hopefully give you a better idea of who Jesus is and how equip you to how you can respond to people in your life that are maybe bringing forward some of these ideas of maybe who Jesus was. Because honestly, a lot of people have these ideas about who Jesus is, and you'll begin to find out, okay, as these people are talking, some of this stuff is wild. But it's not uncommon, unfortunately. So we're going to begin here with Pastor Vicky. Pastor Vicky. I don't know why I put the quotes on Vicky. I know her name. I know her name is Vicky. That's not in question. That's not in the quotes. What's in the quotes is pastor. The fact that she calls herself a pastor, and yet she says she doesn't understand why Jesus came to die. Well, let's listen to Pastor Bo. See, I did it wrong again. Pastor Vicky. Once again, I want to give this disclaimer. This isn't a channel all about, oh my goodness, these people are so bad. Look how trash they are. Smite them, you know, trigger people, like, you know, bombastic. That's not what it's about. Ultimately here, we're not only just about, oh, we want to tear down people. No, we want to correct error, but our goal is to follow Jesus daily. That is our goal. And how are we going to follow Jesus daily if we don't know who he is? So the idea of this video is to help us truly understand who Jesus is so we can follow him in our daily lives and we can help other people follow him. Okay, now on to Pastor Vicky.
Pastor Vicky, did Jesus die for our sins?
That is a line that the church has used for hundreds of years that does not really make sense to me. Jesus died because Jesus challenged the status quo, and the leaders of the church at the time and the leaders of the Roman Empire were not happy with his challenges to love one another, treat all fairly, and to welcome the most marginalized in the community. That is why Jesus died. He was killed by those who feared him.
What? When someone that claims to be a pastor doesn't even understand why Jesus came to this earth, why he died on the cross, that is a major red flag. Like, I'm just telling you, that's like red flag number one. I feel like that should be like the first question they ask you when you enroll in whatever pastor school. But even beyond that, she's neglecting so much scripture here. Even just the basics, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And then we understand, okay, well, we got to do some, you know, pull back, backpedal a little bit, because we're like, okay, why would we perish in the first place? And we find out, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, and that the wages of sin is death. And so we're like, okay, now John 3:16 makes sense. Once we understand the bad news of sin, we can understand the good news of the gospel. But what Pastor Vicky here is trying to purport is that that wasn't really what Jesus was about. He was more kind of a social activist. He was executed. He was killed. He was crucified because they weren't happy because he wanted to teach people how to love each other. You know, he was just some sort of hippie that came down from the sky and he was like, y'all, I want to tell you how to love each other. Just love people. I mean, I've said this before, but let me say it again. Jesus wasn't just a hippie. He wasn't just some guy that came from the sky that just wanted to teach us how to love each other and that all you need is love. No, he told us that we are all broken people, that we need to repent for the kingdom of God is at hand and that he is the only way to God. That is like the opposite of what Pastor Vicky wants to believe, but that's what the Bible says. Do I think that Pastor Vicky holds to the Bible? Probably not, based on her answer. But it's important that we understand who Jesus was. A lot of people will try to cling on to Jesus as just some nice guy that said nice things and just kind of, you know, was all about love. Love one another as you love yourself. And like, okay, yeah, Jesus was about love. Okay, that's cool. But he was also about truth. And he said he is the truth. And he said he is the way. And you can't forget about that. You can't like disconnect those aspects of who Jesus is. You can't disconnect. And this is the whole thing that I find so troubling is that so many people want to separate aspects of God's character. They like the grace, the love, the truth, but they don't like the wrath, the judgment, all that kind of thing. Like they don't like that. But to me, you won't understand the beauty of God's love and his grace until you understand the power that he has in his wrath and in his judgment. Like that's when you truly understand the beauty of what all happened here. When we understand, oh man, we were like left for dead, like because of our sin. We were like deserving of all of God's wrath because we've sinned. Like that's crazy. Oh my goodness. Without Jesus, we would be in big trouble. And then you see God's grace and you see the loving compassion that Jesus showed. It's like, whoa, we did not deserve that at all. That's amazing. But they want to minimize it. They want to just show Jesus as some like God in the flesh social activist. Jesus was so much more than that. And I feel like I don't need to say this, but if anybody that is teaching you or claims to be a pastor says that Jesus didn't die for sins, like that wasn't his ultimate mission, is not fit to be a pastor. I'm sorry. Okay, so bring this into application mode as daily disciples of Jesus. What are we going to take from this? Well, we need to understand that, look, we need to have a firm grasp of why Jesus came to die. We need that to have that. That's our foundation, right? When we understand that, that has implications throughout our whole life. When we understand our sin and Jesus' grace and his acceptance of us, even though we don't deserve it, that's huge. That's amazing. That means we live our lives not out of fear of condemnation or like we gotta love enough or do enough good stuff in order to gain his love. It's like, no, we couldn't do that well enough to earn God's love, but Jesus' goodness is enough for us. His grace is enough for us. He covered us with that grace, with that sacrifice. And that gives us freedom. And so part of what I want to share with you is when we understand who Jesus really is, that gives us great freedom in the truth because he said he is the truth. And the lie, when we believe lies, that's just bondage. And so many people, like Pastor Vicky, I'm just going to call her Vicky, honestly. Vicky's living in bondage. Okay, let's do it. Video number two. Let's go.
Folks like you amuse me. First of all, Jesus died for everybody. He didn't just die for people that believe in him.
Okay, so we started off with Vicky, who claimed that Jesus didn't die for anybody. But now we go to this guy who says Jesus died for everybody. Now, this is an idea called universalism. Now, some denominations, some churches, the Universalist Unitarian Church, they kind of has, this is their big thing. They're like, okay, Jesus died for everyone. There are multiple paths to God. Obviously, I like not biblical. Like it only takes us like one verse to understand that. John 14:6, and Jesus said to them, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And that makes it very clear to us. And so some people will say, okay, well, were those really Jesus' words, right? There's some people, like red letter Christians, I'm only going to listen to the words of Jesus. But even some of them, they only like the nice words of Jesus. They don't like the exclusive words that cause division. They don't like that division that's there. But what I'm really passionate about, and I want you to know, is that truth divides. Truth divides. When we cling on to a lie, it may bring more people into the fold, right? We may say, oh, look, everybody's going to go to heaven. Jesus died for everyone. And that may make us feel nice, right? But ultimately, that is not a loving thing directed for our neighbors, right? Because we're not truly loving our neighbors if we're not actually sharing the truth with them about what the Bible says and who Jesus claimed he was. He claimed he was the only way. And so, well, some people will say, well, just kind of be nice about it, you know, just... It's nicer to just kind of be inclusive to everyone. The nicest thing, the most loving thing you can do is share the truth about who Jesus said he was in love. Well, how does that play itself out? Well, let's just use an example of sharing the gospel with somebody. Back in the day, before COVID, I used to do a lot of street witnessing. I'd love to get back to it at some point, hopefully when things open up a little bit more. But I would share the gospel with people and I would ask them, do they consider themselves to be a good person? Now, I got that line from Ray Comfort of Living Waters Ministry. It's great. And it's just an in to explore the idea of what makes a person good and do we measure up to God's standard? Well, ultimately, we end up on the fact that none of us can measure up to God's standard. And that is a tough truth to swallow. It really is. But once we understand the reality, right, we need to understand reality. That's huge. We don't want to be blinded and or you know, just put shutters on or tunnel vision. I don't want to see the truth about what's going on here, who Jesus is, who I am in light of God's goodness. But once your eyes are open to that, whoa, like conviction comes in. God's law is written on our heart. Whoa, I have sinned against God. And then you're able to present the good news. Say, hey, look, you know, we're all deserving of God's judgment because of our sin. And you recognize that and you are convicted by the Holy Spirit because we, you know, our conscience testifies to us that we've all sinned. But then there's Jesus, fully God and fully man, came to this earth to live the sinless life, the life that we could not live, to die on the cross, the death we deserve to die for our sins against God. And he rose again on the third day, defeating sin and death. And what he calls us to do is repent and put our faith in him. I don't give people room saying, well, Jesus is, this is just one way you could think about the world, or you could just, this is one way to get to heaven. No, this is the way to get to heaven. And I want to put this, I want to speak this truth over your life because, I don't know how much time I have left. I'm called to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, discipling the nations. And so by just speaking the truth and leaving the rest to God, that is ultimately what we're called to do. And it may be tough. We may get negative responses because it's not the fluffy, nice, Jesus saves everyone, no matter what you believe, but it is the truth, and that's what's most important. Okay, the last video here is a pastor who affirms Satanists. Yeah, you didn't hear me wrong on that. Just watch the video.
Hi, everyone. I wanted to come on and respond to a few comments that I'm getting from Christians on a video where I say that I support Satanists as Satanists. Well, I'm getting some comments from Christians like this who say that I am a wicked false pastor and other comments demanding that I repent. Well, guess what? I'm not going to repent. And I don't care if you think I'm a wicked false pastor. I'm still here to support Satanists. Do you know why? Because why? Satanists are not on here hating other people. In fact, Satanists are working in the world to make it a more just and loving place.
Okay, number one, this guy's priorities are whack. Okay, he's like, okay, you know what? We support the Satanists because you know why? They're about love. They're about justice. They want to make the world a better place. So we give our stamp of approval on them. You guys are good to go because look, it's just about loving people. It's just about justice. It's just about making the world a nice, beautiful place. And that's all that matters. Like, bro, you call yourself a pastor and that yet you're forgetting about the main point, right? Maybe if you guys seen a lot of my content. You'll notice that at the end of a lot of shorter videos, I say follow for more Christ-centered content. And the reason I do that is because everything that I create, I want Christ to be at the center. I don't want love to be at the center. I don't want justice to be at the center. I don't want to make the world a better place or live a better life or, you know, be nicer to your family or any of that stuff to be at the center, because everything ought to flow from our relationship with Jesus, from that connection to Jesus. Now, well, people like this may seem really like, oh, you know, nice and oh, like I just about love, whatever. They operate out of this idea of coercion rather than connection. They just want you to do this because, oh, it's good. Just love people. That's the best thing. As long as you're loving people, then you're on the right path. But what the Bible presents to us is to become connected to Jesus in relationship, in an amazing, tight, intimate relationship through the grace of God, only through that grace and the work of Jesus on the cross. But then from there, from that connection, then obedience flows. But this guy, his idea is like, okay, well, look, you know, just do more, just do better, just love people. That's all you need to do. But that's not enough because we can't do that perfectly. And you have your stuff out of order for the Christian, right? We need that connection first, that connection to Jesus for anybody, not just Christian. Obedience always flows out of connection. So that's where we begin, right? And this guy's standard. Now, so that's kind of a separate thing. I realize I'm all over the place, but we're going with it. We're going with it. Okay. But then we go to this idea that this guy affirms Satanists because, look, they're loving people. That's kind of the highest thing on his tier list, you know? Like, he's like, okay, well, as long as you're doing the justice thing and the love thing well, it doesn't really matter what you believe about Jesus or God or anything like that, because that's kind of secondary. It's like, bro, you got your priorities out of check, my guy. Like, how many times do I need to say it? How many times do I need to quote the verses to like get you guys to realize that Jesus is the point? Jesus is the point. Jesus is the point. I could say it all day, but it's true. And so love is not the point. Love flows out of a relationship with Jesus. Justice is not the point. Justice flows out of a relationship with Jesus. And so what the Satanists are missing, they are missing the most fundamental piece, is that relationship with Jesus, is the idea that, look, we all have sin, we all have brokenness, we all have shortcomings, we all cannot love well enough to be saved, we all cannot perform and execute justice well enough to be saved. Our goodness is not good enough. The Satanist goodness, no matter how much they try to make the world a better place and just so beautiful and flowers and rainbows and ponies, it won't be enough. It won't be. And by affirming people just because they have good intentions or they're nice and giving them the stamp of approval, say your approval, you're good to go. That's not loving. That's not loving, because good intentions aren't enough. Trying your best isn't enough. That's why we need Jesus, bro. That's why we need Jesus. And some people let that lurk over their shoulders and cause the weight of shame, because they always feel like they're not measuring up. They always feel like they're falling short. They always feel like they're not enough, that they're not whole. But through Jesus, we experience that wholeness, that even though we may struggle with the sense of shame and guilt, we know that we've been bought with a price and we're free. And yes, that may take a while to internalize. It may take your whole life to really internalize that grace and that freedom and that rest, but it's available in Jesus. It's not available in just doing good things and becoming an environmentalist and in recycling more or trying to be a better person. It won't be enough. So I'd encourage you, if you have questions about who Jesus is, look to the Word of God. Don't take anybody's opinion or word for it. Look to the Word of God to actually find out who is this Jesus guy, and let that impact how you see yourself. And what you've been called to do, what Jesus has called you to do, and who he's called you to be. Because look, My whole mission with this channel is to help you find Jesus and follow him daily. I think this video is a pretty good example of that. We want to learn what Jesus' true character is. We want to find out what he's really like. And now we want to find out, how do we follow him daily? And we got to listen to his teachings, be in community with other believers where we can be encouraged and helped along the way. And I don't think we should do that alone. So thank you for walking with me and watching this video. I really appreciate each and every one of you that has subscribed. It's been pretty unbelievable, to say the least, over the last month or so. I've been at this for 3 years, and I hate to do this little reflective thing at the end of the video or whatever, but you know, stay along if you want to hear it. But I've been at this thing for 3-4 years, and just kind of doing my best to stay faithful to the calling that God has given me. And it's just so encouraging and exciting to see so many people coming alongside and being like, yes, we support you, and we're benefiting from what God's doing. And so that's so exciting for me. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for subscribing to my channel, and thank you for supporting me on Patreon. It means so much to me, and it's so exciting that we're on the path to me being able to do this full time one day. It's not here yet, but the more people that come alongside and support, the closer we get. So thank you so much for that. I hope you benefited from this video, and I will see you next time. God bless.